This video would be more useful for those PhD students who are just starting their PhD or they are in the early period of their PhD. But anyone is welcome to watch this video. In this video, I will be showing you three things which in my opinion can organize your PhD. And I normally don't create suspense in my PhD videos. I do this in my other videos. So therefore, I have listed the topics here because I know how important is time for a PhD student. Unfortunately, most of the PhD students, they don't realize this. And when they start their PhD, they get some free time. They start to enjoy their life. They start some new hobbies or new entertainment activities. And these kind of students suffer later in their PhD. But let's get started. And these three things are listed here. So if you already know about LaTeX, what is the importance of a diary, and why to use Evernote application, then you are welcome to skip. But if not, we are starting just after this short break. Hello and welcome to my channel. My name is Tahir, and if this is your first time, please hit the subscribe button and also the notification bell to get notified whenever I post a new video on this channel every Tuesday and Friday. I have talked about some of these in my previous videos as well. So the first point is LaTeX. Now, LaTeX is a typesetting software which we use for writing our thesis or our research papers. So when we say it's free software, most students, they tend to think that it's free, it might not have any value. And the second problem is that it has a learning curve. You need to spend some time to learn LaTeX. So now here is the point. LaTeX is not just free. It is the best software for typesetting your document. The professional quality you get in LaTeX documents, you cannot achieve this quality in any other software, including Word or OpenOffice or any other software. So you should realize this, that LaTeX is not just free, LaTeX is the best. The only problem is the learning curve. So in this video, I'm going to show you a strategy which you can use, and this will not be a problem at all for you. Because the key point here is that you don't have to learn all the LaTeX. LaTeX is a very big software. You don't have to learn everything. And this is the strategy which I'm going to show you. So this strategy has three components. So the first part of this strategy is get the LaTeX installations on your laptop or on your computer. I normally use PC. I don't like laptops, but you can install it on your laptop as well. Now I have a video on how to get the LaTeX working on your computer, and I will put that in the description of this video so you can watch that video, and this part will be done and dusted within maybe 2 or 3 hours. So before I explain the second part, the important thing to understand for you is that you only need one template which you can use to write your thesis, and then you need templates for the organization such as IEEE where you want to publish your papers. The way we work on LaTeX is we prepare our template and then we use it again and again. I am still using my lecture templates which I created in 2008 after 11 years. And if you create some template in, for example, Word or in OpenOffice, your templates will not work after maybe 3 months. And they will definitely not work after 3 years. But LaTeX templates, they work for years. So this is the important thing you should understand. You don't have to learn all the LaTeX. You just have to create a template for you. So the second part of the strategy is on your computer, make 3 folders. In folder number 1, you will create a template called Learning Template, My Learning Template. In folder number 2, you will create a second template called My Thesis Template. And in folder number 3, you will create subfolders, IEEE and other organizations folder where you want to publish your papers, the organizations which you are targeting for your papers, publications. So in the 3rd folder, you will create templates for those organizations, and that I am not talking in this video. I have one video for IEEE, which you can watch. I will put the link in the description. Installations and then making the templates for your learning and thesis. So what is learning template? Learning template will be your template which will be growing over time. So for example, today you learned how to insert images in LaTeX. So you got some code and that code is working and you put that code into your learning template. Next day you learn how to put references in LaTeX, how to make bibliography. You got some code, the code is working, you put that code into your learning template. Then the third day you learned how to write equations in LaTeX, mathematical equations. You put that code into your learning template. Now this code once working is it for you. That's it. If once you got this code, once you know how to make this work, this will work forever for you. So this is how you work in LaTeX. So how to grow this learning template? You have to learn by watching other videos. For example, on YouTube, there are hundreds of videos available on YouTube free, which you can learn from. On my channel, you will find many videos how to use LaTeX, and you don't have to buy any courses. But if you do, I have two courses, and one is a short course focused on PhD only, how to write thesis, and one is a long LaTeX course. So I will offer you free coupon for the short course, which is for PhD. So that you can see in the link of this video. Udemy offers only 3 days. After 3 days, this coupon will expire. Unfortunately, they have changed their policy. But I will put a link here and you can enroll in my thesis course, which is a short course. For long course, you have to purchase if you want, but you don't have to purchase. You can watch free videos on my channel and you can still learn. Now the third part of this LaTeX strategy is that you dedicate at least 30 minutes until you have finished making these two templates, your learning template and your thesis template. So this is your strategy about LaTeX, that learn a little bit, put into your template and then use it again and again. Now on your thesis template, what you will do, when you start writing your thesis, now your focus will be towards your final document. And now you have to put only specific things into your thesis template. For example, bibliography, dedication page, abstract, acronyms, glossaries. So these are the things which are specialized for PhD thesis. And all of this you will learn in this free course, which I'm offering to my YouTube subscribers. So you can enroll in this course and you can learn. So this is it for your LaTeX strategy. Now let's talk about the second point, Digit Idea Diary 1. What is this? Because I make a lot of videos about PhD students and I have a lot of following on YouTube. So students ask questions. What I realized is that if I could make a diary for these students, because I have talked about the importance of diary in my other videos, so why not create a diary for these students? So now luckily with Amazon on-demand publishing, we can do this. So therefore I decided to make this diary. I just made the template of the diary and put it on the Amazon website. Now from where you can purchase, and Amazon will publish it and send it to you. Let me give you a brief introduction to this diary. This is a normal diary as any other diary on which you can take notes. But in addition to that, I have put some prompts for you, and those prompts will encourage you to put some information on that diary. This diary encourages you to do something, to take some action, to record some information. What this diary has will organize your PhD for you. This diary contains few pages where you can record the meetings with your PhD supervisor. When this meeting happened, what was the key point? Then this diary contains few pages where you can write your target conferences, your target journals, what experiments you want to do, what survey you want to conduct, what are the hurdles for your PhD, what are the top researchers in your field, what are the possible paper titles you are thinking about. So one day you got some idea about a topic of your research paper. You can write that into that area of this diary, because I have provided these columns and everything where you can write this information. So this will organize your PhD so that during your course of PhD, you might need one or two diaries, but you will only consult these diaries and you will focus on your studies. So this was a brief introduction to this diary. I will put a link in the description of this video, and also there is a my Amazon influencer page at the bottom of this description, where you can also purchase this diary if you want. Because there is some cost involved in publishing, so I cannot offer you this free to you. But you don't have to purchase this. I have shown you how I made these columns. I have shown you on the screen what is inside the diaries. You can make these columns on your own diary, and then you can use that as your PhD diary. Now, the third thing I have mentioned here is an application called Evernote. For PhD, I want to use this application only for one purpose. So therefore, I'm not explaining this Evernote application in this video. I have made another video in which I have explained a little bit about Evernote, which is titled something like Three Best Apps or something like that. You can watch that video. But the purpose of mentioning Evernote here is very important, that when you are doing your PhD, sometimes diary is not with you, but your mobile phone is with you. So what you can do with this Evernote is that you can quickly take the picture of something and you can store it. And this picture will be permanently stored on the cloud, because Evernote, even the free version, provides you some free storage. So you can take a picture of something very important for your PhD and that will be stored forever. Similarly, if you saw a particular portion of a book very important for you, so instead of writing that whole part of that paragraph into your diary, you can take a picture of that, and then that picture you can consult later on while writing a paper, for example. This is why I think is that Evernote is very important for any PhD student to install and use it on a regular basis. So you have to make this as your habit. Otherwise, you won't be able to get the full benefit of this application. So these were my three picks for you today, that if you use these three things, if you start learning LaTeX now, if you start using a diary now, and if you start using this Evernote application, your PhD will be 100% organized and under your complete control. So I hope you like this video. If so, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. Thanks for watching, and see you next time.